Hello, how are you guys doing tonight? I thought I would do a tutorial for the Christmas song, not just a Christmas song, the Christmas song, because I just learned it for a little piano gig that I had to play last week, and it's just my own version of it. It's kind of a medley of different songs, but today I'm just going to focus on the Christmas song part of that medley. It's not really a good one for singing along with because I changed the melody line at one point, but it sounds nice. It's like a jazzy version. So I'm going to play through it so that you guys can get an idea of what it is, and then I'll break it down. Oh, wow. I apologize. And then see if you can't learn it. So I think it'll be fine. Here it is. All right. So there it is. That's my version of it. It doesn't go with the words, as I said, but I like to play it. It's fun. It's kind of nice. It's really good background music for a Christmas party or whatnot. So yeah, there's a lot to it in terms of chords, more than most of my songs, I would say, that I've done on here in terms of, like, well, the left hand's pretty straightforward. It's usually just octaves, but I'll just go through it and make sure you review this a couple times if you're trying to learn it. But I think you should be able to get it. So I'm just going to play through it slow for one part, and then I'll show it, and then I'll do the same thing. All right? So here's the first part. Okay. So that is C octave in the left hand. I'm not sure if you can see it, but if you can, it's right here. C octave. And then inverted C chord, so E, G, C. And also, I throw a G in the left hand as well, in the middle, so it's G, C, G, C. I realize I do that, so to fill up that chord a little bit more, so it's that. And then you jump up to a C, just play the C by itself, and then move the left hand up to a D, just one note, so D. And I also throw an A in there, so it's a D, A, D. And then I go like this, which is G and B, F and A together, E and G, D and F. So it just walks down. Okay, so it's just thirds on that, that's what it is. And that is, in the left hand, it's an E, B, and E. And then it's a A, D, G. Oh, I lied. It's a G, D, G. I'm sorry, it's late. G, D, G, there. And then it goes up to this chord. And I don't usually play the C in the left hand, so I would just play an F octave like that. And then it's a A flat, a D, an E, and a G. And then I walk down like this, which is an F, E, D, and then go back to the first chord I showed you, which is a C, G, C, E, G, C, like that. So that whole part should sound like this. Okay, and I syncopated the second one, so hit the left hand. And I hit that three times. And then I hit an E after, so. Okay, so work on the syncopation on that afterwards. It comes. And if you play them nice and soft, if you follow the kind of crescendos and decrescendos, if you can hear them, that helps. It makes it more like jazzy and sound nice like that. So that's the first section. And then this is the second section. Okay, there's a lot to that. It starts with the same C chord that you end on the last thing with. So that is the same chord. It's a C, G, C, E, G, C. And instead of jumping to a C as we did the first time, you're going to jump up to an A. And then you're going to make this chord. With the left hand, you're jumping also to a G. So just G octave. And then this chord right here is a B flat, a D, an E, and a G right there. Okay. So that's again F E D. Oh, that's it. So I do change that a little bit. I'm sorry. Here we go. So it's F E F G. That's down to an F octave in the left hand. And what I do here is I just hit an A, and I roll up from C, so it's C, D, E, and then down to a C, so it's making an A chord over the F, which is actually an F7 right there, if anyone cares. And so that's that. Let's see. And then I go. What do I jump to on that? Wow, I'm sorry. Let's just stay on an F then, because I can't figure it out, so. Okay, well, let's just stay on an F then. So it's a B flat. That's what it is. Okay, so everything we just played is. And then this is the new chord. So it's a B flat with your third finger. I like to play it that way at least. In the left hand, and that's all you're playing. And then it's a A flat, C, D, G, and then I end with an F afterwards, so it's, so you hit the chord, and then go to an F with your fourth finger there, C, D, so it's, okay, that's that part. Let me play through it one more time, because I messed that up a lot, so let's just see. Okay, so that's that part, and then the next part is right here. Here we go. So it's an A in the left hand, which I don't think you can see, but it's an A octave. And then it goes down to an A flat octave in the left hand. then a G octave. And then a G flat. It just walks down, so. Oh, yeah. I skipped the middle one. Okay, so it goes G, A, A flat, G, G flat. So just like that. So in the right hand, it is an E, an A, and a C. And you hit that twice. And then it goes B, C, which is the transition. And that chord right there is over the A flat in the left hand. And it's an A flat, a C, and a D. And you hit it twice. And then you just do the two notes you're already on, and it's a C, D. And that's just a inverted G chord with a G in the left hand. So it's a G, C, E. And then you jump up to a G to an A. So. Yeah, I actually, if you don't have the reach for this, you don't have to do it, but in the left hand I'm playing a G flat, and then I do an A, E, B chord, but a lot of people's hands aren't this big, so I would say I would just leave out that note there and just go up to an E and a B instead of that, but if you can get the A, it adds a nice thing to it there, but if not, that's alright too. I would not play the A here too, because that sounds a little muddled there, I think. Okay, so just like that. So that whole part goes like this. And then there's an A afterward. And if you notice, I don't know if you're wondering, but in the left hand, I'm doing up. So it's... I don't know how to describe that rhythm, but it's... So... And I jump up on that last one to this G flat. Okay, and then drop down to the A. So that's that whole part. And then the next part goes like this. Just a transition. For my medley of songs that I put together, it adds a nice transition into the next song. It's not the written way this is actually supposed to be played. And I'm shaking the camera like crazy, I'm sorry. There we go. But it goes like this. And it goes into Oh Christmas Tree in my medley, but I'll show that one later. We'll go with this for now. So in the left hand is an E flat. And then in the right hand, it's a G flat, a B flat, a D flat, and an E flat. And then in the right hand, all you change is this D flat goes down to a C. And in the left hand, it goes down to an A flat only. So E flat in the left hand, down to an A flat in the left hand. And then the whole chord slides down, except for this, which goes up right here, the E flat to the E. And then you go to a D octave in the left hand. And then F, A, C, E in the right hand. Yeah, and then I walk down with a D, C. And then it's just... It's a inverted D chord, D minor, right there, which is an F, an A, and a D. And in the left hand, I'm playing a G, which really goes into the next part nicely. And then I hit a G up here, and I walk down F, so actually it's G, F, E, D, and then don't play the C because it's going to be in the chord. note on this song that's a lot of people mess up on is playing this too fast. In general, a lot of people play piano too fast when they're performing. So I'm not sure how you want to personally deal with it, but I always just think constantly, just slow down, no matter what, because in a jazz piece like this, you can play it however you want. It doesn't matter the timing of it, so you don't have to worry about keeping it in time. Like, you could go... something like that. I mean, you can slow it down. That sounded kind of bad, but I think you get what I mean. Just make sure you play it slow so it sounds nice. If you rush it, it doesn't sound too good. The alternate ending that I played when I went through the whole thing at the beginning, I'll show you now just so you can end it. I came up with these chords. I think it sounds nice in the left hand. I'll show you where it comes in afterwards, but right now I'll just go through the chords. It is like this. And actually, if you go up higher, it sounds better, so we'll go with this for now. So that chord right there is a C, E, G, and B. So it's a C7. And then you leave the C and move the E up to an F and make this B into an A. And three in a row, so C, F, G, A. Alright? Might take some getting used to. This stretch right here is really strange at first. Alright? So, in the right hand, it's gonna be. Okay, so that in the right hand is just C, A, G, C. So that just over and over again. And if you want to at the end, instead of going down, you can go up, so. And that chord and that little two notes that I hit at the end there is, it's just a B and a D. And then it resolves, well, it doesn't really, because I hit the ninth of this, but it's, the chord down here is a C octave, and then an E, G, B, D. And a lot of people want it to end like that, but in jazz it helps to end it with, you know, kind of a dissonant chord that leaves it kind of open-ended. That's how, I don't know, that's just how they do it. And it sounds nice, and you can just let it kind of hang there once you're done playing. So, in terms of where that goes in the song, I'll play through it real fast, and then, not fast speed, but just quickly, and then I'll show you where it comes in. So here it is. So that's where it is. It's the alternate ending for, instead of that transition part that I put in there. So that's where it comes in. I'll play through the full thing one more time. I feel like this video is missing something, probably essential. So just make sure to comment and let me know if I missed anything. It is late. So I'll play through it one more time, and if I can't think of it, I'll post it and let me know what you think about it, all right? Thanks a lot, and here it is. All right, thanks for watching, and make sure to comment, rate, and subscribe to me if you like what just happened. So, thanks for watching.